In this video, we want to find out how to change the control flow of an expert advisor by using switch and case. In our little example here, we have an output. The customer wants RSI. And now we are going to find out how to change that by using switch and case. To do that, please click on the little button here or press F4 in Metatrader. Now you should see the Metaeditor window, and here you want to click on File, New, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file SimpleSwitchCase, click on Continue, Continue and Finish. And now you can delete everything above the OnTick function. And let's also remove the two command lines here. We start with an integer variable called choice. In our case, the initial value for our choice is 5. And based on that choice, we want to calculate an entry string. In our case, we don't assign any value because we want to calculate that later on. So let's use the switch statement to go through our choices. Let's add two curly brackets here, and everything within these two curly brackets will be executed. The first case is if the value equals 5, and when that is the case, we want to add the text, the customer wants RSI to our entry. In this video, we are using a plus and an equal sign that has to do with a special kind of behavior that I'm going to explain later on. For now, let's add a break statement. Break is where we are going to leave the switch and case loop because the break operator terminates the execution of the nearest nested outward switch loop. Let's add another case here. If our value is 4, we want to add the text, the customer wants Bollinger Bands. For the value 3, we want to add the text, the customer wants MACD. You could also do a little calculation inside of the two round brackets here, but it's not possible to use variables. That would cause an error. So in case that our value is 1 plus 1, we want to add the text, the customer wants random entries to our entry. Last but not least, we can add a default option. The default branch will be executed when none of the above statements is true. And in that case, we add the text, customer does not know, to our entry. Finally, we use the command statement to create an output on our chart. So far, so good. Now please click on the compile button here or press F7. I have a special character here that I need to remove. Let's recompile the code. Now we don't have any errors and no warnings, so we can click on the little button here or press F4 to go back to Metatrader. And in Metatrader we click on View, Strategy Tester or press Ctrl and R. Here we pick the new file simpleswitchcase.ex4. Please enable the visual mode here and start a test. Now we get the output, the customer wants RSI. So let's change the value. Let's pick 4, recompile the code, stop the current test and start a new one. And now we get the customer wants Bollinger Bands. Let's pick a value that is not in our list, recompile again, and now we should get the text, the customer does not know, because 11 is not in our list, and that causes the default option to be executed. Well, there is a special thing that you might not know. If we remove the break statements here, or if we simply forget them, we also change our choice value back to 5. Now we recompile the code. And now we get the output, the customer wants RSI, and the customer wants Bollinger Bands, and the customer wants MACD. Because the switch case statement is executed from the first case that is actually true, and it will run through all the options until it hits the next break statement. Even if our value is 5, The code for case 4 and for case 3 is executed. So let's keep that in mind. I'm not the biggest fan of the switch case statement. I rarely use it. But now you know how to use switch and case to change the control flow of your expert advisor, and you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL4 code.